In this video, we'll balance the equation for HgS plus O2. This is mercury to sulfide, and this is oxygen gas. So the first thing we'll do, we'll count the atoms up. We have one mercury atom, one sulfur, and two oxygens. On the product side, we have one mercury, one sulfur, and then one oxygen. Plus, don't forget these two here. So we have three oxygen atoms. Probably the best thing to do at this point is try to get this to an even number. So if I put a 2 in front of the HgO, I'll have 1 times 2. So I'll have 2 mercury atoms. And then the oxygens, we need to update those. 2 times 1 is 2 plus these 2 here. That'll give us 4. So we have an even number. The problem at this point is that we need to put a 2 here to balance the mercury. So now we have 1 times 2. That'll give us 2 mercury atoms. But the sulfur, 1 times 2, that'll give us 2 of those. So we're going to have to put a 2 in front of the SO2. 1 times 2, that'll give us 2 of those. Let's update the oxygens again. 2 times 1 is 2, plus 2 times 2 is 4, so we have 6. But since we left the oxygen till last, the oxygen here is all by itself. So if I just put a 3 here, I'll have 2 times 3, that'll give me 6. The oxygens are balanced. Since oxygen's by itself, it doesn't change the mercury or the sulfur, the number of those atoms. So we're done. This is the balanced equation. Two things to be careful here. Make sure you count up all of the oxygens when you start. That's very important. And then leave the oxygens till last when you're balancing, especially because this oxygen here, this O2, is by itself. We change this, it won't change the mercury or the sulfur. This is Dr. B with the balanced equation for HgS plus O2. Thanks for watching.